anybody that writes about whatever I say today, you call me Ocho Cinco. Do not say Chad.
What's up, everybody? I'm Sophie Julia, and we are here at Chad Ochocinco's house. He's outspoken. He's a social media genius. He makes headlines. He was crazy on the field. Maybe he's crazy off the field. Let's head inside and check out his crib. All right, Chad's lighting a cigar in his electric robe. That's the way to answer a door and make an entrance.
It is.
Do cigars get you high?
They don't do anything for me. Honestly, I've been doing it since, this is the thing, cigars, I started in 1993, I think maybe my sophomore year in high school, mm-hmm. when everybody was drinking and smoking weed. I was trying to figure out a way to fit in without having to deal with the extracurricular activities,
yeah.
and cigars was my vice, and that was my outlet, so I could be around everybody, drinking and smoking the weed.
Looking cool.
And this was my whole look cool thing, and I've been doing it since then.
Let's check out the house. This chandelier is pretty amazing. Did you move into it decorated?
Mm-mm.
Or
no,
you did this?
You moved into them, yeah. You had to do everything. Everything is basic, basic models you get. And you have to add your own taste to it. It's like getting dressed. They sell you the clothes, but you have to add your own accessories. Same thing goes with the place.
You think you'll live in Miami forever?
Yeah, I don't want to. There's nothing like home.
You grew up in Miami.
Born and raised Liberty City.
So you would come here in the off seasons.
Yeah,
and now you're
off season to be right home.
Here.
So now I'm here.
So I know you have a beautiful kitchen in here,
mm-hmm.
but I heard that you only eat at McDonald's, true or false?
True. I mean, everybody knows that. That's been a staple of mine for what, the past, what, 15, 16, 17 years?
So all three meals?
Yeah, damn near.
No.
Especially during my plan days. During my plan days, it was really bad. It got to the point where Coach Lewis, the organization had a nutritionist come in. And it just didn't do anything for me. And I continued to eat McDonald's, you know, morning, noon, and breakfast.
Well, I mean, it works because you were still in shape.
In shape, yeah. And still
you're probably the only person that can eat McDonald's three times a day and be in shape.
Yeah, yeah. Don't get tired. Doesn't affect
me. Is that your genes or do you work out a lot?
I just work out, I guess. I'm sure genes has something to do with it, though.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
What's your order at McDonald's?
Number one, extra cheese, no onions, Coke with no ice.
What is the number one?
Big Mac.
So that's how you can have such a nice house, because you saved all your money while playing.
I'm so cheap. That's probably one of the reasons why I can't keep a woman either.
That, you know what? Cheap's a really bad quality.
Yeah, it is. It is. It's been a real part, a real, real problem of mine, because I don't spend, you know, so I mean, what are you offering me? The vagina doesn't pump out 20s and 50s. You know, you can get it free elsewhere. You can get it anywhere.
So what does a woman have to offer you to get you to pay for dinner? Because I saw, let me backtrack a minute.
Backtrack.
I saw that at the end of dinner, when you go to pay the bill, mm-hmm. you whip out a deck of Uno cards.
To pay, yeah.
And you make them play Uno to decide who pays
the bill. Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
And if I went to dinner with you and I lost at Uno,
mm-hmm.
I would have to pay?
Yeah, you would have to pay the bill. It's 50-50. You guys always fighting for equal rights, right?
Honestly,
Am I right, I want
the guy to pay and I won't fight for my equal rights.
Okay.
I'm always poor. I'm always the one with less money, so.
No such thing. There's always, just remember, there's always someone doing worse than you and you're doing just fine.
Thanks, Chad. So you have five or six kids?
Six, I need one more.
You need one more?
Seven is the number of completion in the Bible.
Oh, so you always wanted to have seven kids?
Always. Way, 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 way back. So I started
early.
For
a cheap guy, that's really expensive.
Well, you get more out of investing in your kids than you do any woman.
So you splurge on your kids.
Yeah.
Okay, I like that.
Yeah. The kids are never leaving you. Women come and go. You don't want to.
I agree with that. I like that you spend on your kids, but you said the more kids you have, the better the snacks.
Yeah. That is true.
What kind of snacks?
Because
there's nothing in your pantry.
They're not here right now. So when they're coming, on weekends mostly, yeah. It's fucking loaded.
Loaded.
Yeah.
We're allowed to say fuck on Barstool.
For real?
Yeah.
Hey, it's loaded.
Do you know that Barstool is based out of Boston?
Mm-hmm.
And they're big Patriots fans?
They should be. Anyone based out of Boston should be a Patriots fan.
So how did you feel about your time in with the Patriots?
It was great.
It was great.
Great organization. Great environment. A great winning environment, you know? As a fan of the Patriots, for those that are fans of the Patriots, like knowing every year you have a chance at the playoffs and probably a run at the trophy, that has to be a great feeling.
Are you friends with Tom?
Yeah, he gave me some hugs.
He gave you hugs?
Yeah.
Have you hung out with Giselle?
No, I didn't meet her after the Super Bowl, though. She's cool. She's really cool. Especially for someone as powerful as her to be that down to earth, you know?
So you tweet out to people, come challenge me in FIFA, mm-hmm. and you have kids. Are they adults or kids that show up at your house?
Normally adults. Adult, you mean, I don't want to say kid. When you say kids, what age are you referring to? Because it's normally college kids.
Yeah.
Or sometimes
people
adults.
People younger than you.
Yeah, sometimes adults. You know, everybody plays FIFA.
Are you ever worried that someone's going to come in and, like, rob you or, like, have a gun?
Rob me of what?
All your nice things.
What nice? I don't have anything. I'm cheap as hell. Ain't shit nice here.
Yeah, there actually isn't that much stuff in your, yeah. but you have,
no,
you have
I don't,
a nice
I
house.
Don't, I don't have, yeah, it's a nice house, but the things that are in this house are the same things that the normal average human being can afford and buy.
But you're not scared someone's going to come in and just, like, hurt you?
No, I can fight really well.
Where'd you learn how to fight?
Growing up in Liberty City, you didn't have a choice.
Okay. So you're not nervous. That would make me nervous to have a stranger in my home.
You know where I grew up?
Yeah, I went to Miami.
Yeah, Liberty, it's nothing to be scared of, man.
So what do you do in this room?
I'm never in here. Kids are always in here.
This is the kids' room.
Well, not kids' room, but I don't really leave my room, honestly.
So what do you do in your room all day?
FIFA, movies, tweet, sex, tweet.
I love Twitter.
Smoke cigars, that's it.
All right, let's go check out your room. So this is your room. You lay in your bed and play FIFA.
Yeah, that's it.
And watch movies.
Watch movies, there's nothing else to do.
And have sex.
Yeah, yeah, the bed is pretty good for that.
I know that you have a thing for Rihanna, specifically her feet.
Her feet, yeah, that's it, that's her feet.
So you have a foot fetish.
It's not a foot fetish, it's a way of life. If you find a woman that continuously keeps her nails and feet done, then everything else is probably A+.
So, you have a thing for Rihanna's feet, and you said you sent her nudes?
Naked, yeah.
She didn't reply?
I wouldn't either if I was her.
What? It's embarrassing?
No, not for me. And she's, you know, it's just playing around. This Rihanna is not someone I could date. It's not someone that I would have access to. That's not someone that would actually give me the time of day.
What about when you were playing?
Even when I was playing still, it's out of my ballpark in a sense. You know, for me, there's this thing I call when men, they try to chase after certain types of women, knowing that's really not in your financial lane. So you want to...
In your financial lane.
What you want to do is you want to stay within the salary cap. The type of women you deal with, that's extremely important. And I don't know why men do this. You know, like, dude, stay within your salary cap and the type of women that fit your financial structure. If it doesn't fit your financial structure, don't try to fucking chase her.
Outkicking your coverage.
It's all the time.
Rihanna probably wants someone that has close to as much money as her and wants to spend it on her.
Right. Or, yeah, always. Always. It's, again, I still have the same logic goes into it's still just sex. So I can get away with lotion in my imagination and get the same results. Get the same results without having to spend a dime.
This bed is, this is a sex bed.
It is?
This is a sex bed. If I walked into this room, I'm like, this guy's trying to fuck. There's leopard black velvet sheets.
Right. I really wouldn't say the bed is reference to me trying to sleep with you, or just any guy. The fact that he's trying to holler, that's him wanting to have sex in general.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But this is a room that you would think this guy has a lot of sex.
For real?
Yeah.
I don't really have sex much. Maybe once, twice a month.
Really?
At most, if that, yeah. If that. I mean, it's really hard for me to
You're
get
You're very fertile.
Me?
Yeah.
Right. I am. Which is why I don't have sex much.
Are these your games or your DVDs?
Pornos, DVDs.
What kind of porn are you into?
Bondage, threesomes, orgies, gay.
No, you're not.
None of this bullshit. No, I think all these are, you know, it's funny. I think they're all just movies. Just movies and video games. I don't have any porn, do I? I don't have any porn.
So only the kids swim in the pool, you said?
Yeah. I haven't been in that shit since I've been here. And I've been here.
In 6 years?
6, 7 years, yeah.
You've never been in your pool?
No. And I can swim, and I really don't like getting my hair wet.
Same. Always keep the head above water.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And do you party?
No.
Never.
And I rarely have people here. That's why my fucking place is so clean.
So, that's true. I think people would probably expect you to be a big partier.
Everyone thinks that.
But you're not.
They think I drink and I smoke weed, but I freaking never really indulge in either.
So this is the closet.
Not really.
No?
Yeah, one of
some
them.
Some of it?
Yeah, some of it.
This shoe collection is awesome. So these are a lot of Louboutins, and you have outrageous shoe style of it.
I do. I'm very edgy, and some of the shoes that I choose to wear.
Shut the fuck up. Do you wear these?
I haven't yet, but that's why Rihanna wouldn't respond to my DM.
Too big for her. So, did you get these big cock shoes made by Del Toro, or mm-hmm. they sell them?
You make
them. You customized it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Another thing that we have in common is that you buy your diamonds, your diamond earrings at Claire's.
At Claire's.
Me too.
Yeah. It's all of my jewelry throughout my career has been replica. Watches, like, it's replica.
Oh.
Yeah, replica. Oh, it's only $5,000. Shut up. What time is it right now? Just in general.
12:45.
How much did that cost?
Cheaper time than a Rolex.
Time is fucking free. Oh, I got money. Please.
So Chad, when you played in the league, if I was playing, I wouldn't have wanted to play against you. You were kind of a pain in the ass to the other team.
You think so?
Yeah. What were some of the things that you said that we might not have heard to get in the other guys' heads?
Well, you know what? I was never malicious in anything that I ever did. One of the things that really aggravated people a lot, and I'm not sure if you can find the clip, but is that I would always tell people I love you consistently throughout the entire game. Like, consistently tell people and players I love you, especially during TV timeouts. I would go in their huddle and purposely, just small conversations would always throw an opponent's game off. Where we're playing the Ravens, and it's a TV timeout, and I'm talking to one of the D linemen for the Ravens,
yeah.
And Bart Scott comes out of nowhere. He's like, "Man, get the fuck from over here, man!" And I'm like, "I love you, dude. I'm not the bad guy. I'm trying to show you some hospitality. I fucking love you."
Hey, I'm not the bad guy. I love you. I love you. We're trying to show you some hospitality, buddy.
You say I love you to everyone on Twitter every day too.
Every day. I've been doing that for. Since my freshman year in high school, I remember I always use my incident when I messed up. Mm-hmm. For example, I always use my incident when I fucked up as a reason to always love and do it consistently, 24/7, because I stopped loving where I wasn't in my right state of mind for 3 seconds. And that 3 seconds of anger cost me a lifetime's worth of work that took me forever to build. You know, and I always told myself, I remember sitting in jail, and I always told myself, "You fucking idiot. You stopped loving for 3 seconds, and now look," you know? So no matter what was going on, I just always used to be one where everything was water off a duck's back, where nothing bothered me.
Yeah.
And how I let something deter that love that I always had consistently for such a long period of time, and I lost it. Not only did I lose that love for that split moment, but I lost everything it took for me to work, you know what I'm trying to say, so.
Yeah, I do.
That's part of why I continuously still do it to this day.
So you've done a lot of funny things, like sending Pepto-Bismol to the other team.
Yeah, that was fun.
Bribing a ref on the field.
Yeah.
Pulling out a Hall of Fame jacket that you made yourself.
I had to induct myself because I choose not to play the game, the waiting game. You know, there's a waiting game and it's politics that go into all that. I don't have time. I don't need your validation. You know, I don't need your Hall of Fame jacket. I don't need you to say, okay, now it's okay for you to enter. I'm good.
So, what do you think was your funniest on-field antic?
My funniest?
Yeah.
I don't know. The one I enjoyed the most, I would have to say, would have to be the marriage proposal.
To the cheerleader.
Yeah, that was a spur of the moment.
Did she know it was coming?
No. I mean, I think she understood what I was doing, and it was a spur of the moment thing, which is why that was one of the best, that she was able to catch on to what I was doing, and her reaction and everything was priceless.
If you could smoke cigars and hang out and play FIFA with mm-hmm. three people in the entire world,
oh, that's easy. That's easy. Okay. Johnny Depp, Edward Norton, and Daniel Day-Lewis.
All actors?
Yeah. Yeah.
Any yeah. reason why specifically, or you just love their work?
Yeah, just I love their work, and I think those are three people that are unstable mentally to be able to do some of the things that they do in life,
yeah.
especially the roles that they portray. And I would love to sit down with them. Kanye would have been another one, because he's another one who's emotionally not all there. And I think they're all geniuses in their own right within their crafts. But I know Kanye personally, so. But those three, man, especially Daniel Day-Lewis and fucking Johnny Depp, dude. They are, dude.
So the other day, you were on ESPN and you were talking about how you would soak your injuries in other people's urine.
You warm it up. That's a great remedy I learned from my grandmother.
So was it a mix of your teeth? Like, were they peeing for you?
Yeah, if they can pee for the NFL, they can pee for me. What's the difference?
So you would go around and collect their urine?
Yeah, you have to.
So
you know I was never hurt in a 13-year span. I never missed a game.
That's incredible.
I never got hurt, ever. I ate the things people say I shouldn't eat. Never got hurt. You know, I mean, you do things your way, man. Don't let these people brainwash you on the way things are supposed to be. It's not.
Was there anyone who wouldn't piss for you?
No.
Really?
Why would they?
That's weird. I don't want to do
weird.
That.
Weird is pissing for the man for a drug test. That's weird. If you can piss for the man, you can piss for me.
All right. That makes sense. Are you still fast?
Very.
Do you miss playing in the NFL?
No. I don't want to get hit. I miss competing. But I don't want to go through the trenches and what it takes to, no.
Do you still got it? Like, you could do it?
Probably not.
Okay.
Mentally, I know exactly what to do to execute, getting open and catching the ball, mm-hmm. but my body wouldn't register to be able to do it. It wouldn't
right.
register, no. I mean, my body's broken down now.
What do you have to say to the people that said you weren't smart enough to play for the Patriots?
It had nothing to do with it, though.
Yeah, you couldn't understand the playbook.
The game of football will always be the same since the beginning of the time. Regardless of what team you go on, the routes, it's only nine routes you can run.
Yeah.
They don't change. The verbiage from team to team changes. That's it. It's still football.
So people are just talking shit.
And that's it. And you have to understand, I wish people would understand this. You're a Patriot fan, right? Think about this. I mean, you watch football. Name one outside receiver that has ever been extremely successful that plays on the outside that's played for the Patriots ever, besides Randy Moss.
That's what I'm saying.
Just like the system is a great system when it comes to winning, mm-hmm. but it works from the inside out. It's a system for tight ends, small slot receivers, and running backs out the backfield. It's not fit. I was a predominant wide receiver on the outside. I was the first option in Cincinnati. You know, in New England, it's a different ball game. You know, your first option is Wes Welker or Amendola or Gronk. You know, it doesn't work that way. I'm not putting up 1,400 yards in the New England system.
Yeah.
I'm not Randy Moss. He's fucking special. You know, he's a different animal.
Yeah.
They had Aaron Hernandez, Welker, Gronk. Wasn't getting the fucking ball. It didn't fit, you know. Great system. It just didn't fit for my style of play and what I was able to offer.
So you're doing this podcast with Jamie Dukes,
mm-hmm.
Ocho and Dukes.
And the podcast is fun. We started like towards the end of the season, and we have a different person on each week,
mm-hmm.
whether it's football, entertainment, whether it's rap. So we're just getting the ball rolling. We're probably on our sixth episode. The previous one, we just had T.O. on, which is really cool. And I enjoy it, you know? I enjoy the platform, being able to talk and allow people to come on and tell us about what they're doing and whatever their endeavors and crafts are in life.
You were basically the best hype man for Cincinnati. You put eyeballs on that team because nobody really cared.
No, not at all. Nobody watched.
Was that a goal of yours happened?
No, the goal of mine was to be the best I could be regardless of where I ended up,
mm-hmm.
regardless of where I landed. And I think I did just that. You know, I made the best of the cards I was dealt, and I had a great time doing it.
Well, Chad, thank you for letting us into your home. It's a beautiful day. We were happy to come down to Miami.
You're welcome. You guys are welcome anytime. Move in, cook.
Get a robe. All right. We'll be back.
All right.